Well, a dog attack near Patterson Park is dividing that community. Dozens turned out tonight at a meeting expressing concern over dogs running loose, and some are pushing for tougher restrictions on pit bulls in particular. 11 News reporter Carrie Cavanaugh is live right now at Baltimore City Police Headquarters. She has more on this story for us. Carrie?
Baltimore City has no specific rules on the books in regards to pit bulls, and tonight Animal Control made it very clear that they judge each dog on a case-by-case basis instead of indicting the entire breed when something bad happens. It's unclear what will happen to the pit bulls involved in this most recent attack. Some want them put down, but their owner believes they belong at home.
I want those two dogs euthanized.
Joanne Dahlgaud did not mince words when she showed up at a meeting organized in response to the recent pit bull attack on her dog. Misha, her poodle, came along walking well despite the wound she suffered outside her Patterson Park area home on November 18th.
Both dogs were on my dog. He was pressed to the ground, and they were literally ripping out hunks of flesh.
The pit bulls involved belonged to Angel Perez. He says they're gentle family pets that got out after someone damaged his fence.
I really feel bad. I mean, this tore me apart, tore my family apart.
Perez was cited for failing to confine his dogs. Now the pair is being held by Animal Control at Barks, the same shelter where he says they were living when he adopted them. Officials will decide whether they should be euthanized. Meanwhile, Perez is pledging to fight for his dogs. He says he doesn't know what set them off, but he would still trust them with his children.
I like to play with him. Like, we ride them like horses.
At the meeting, police assured concerned neighbors that they are cracking down on dogs running loose, issuing 10 citations in Patterson Park since Misha was attacked. Misha's owner hopes the $200 fine will encourage owners to be more responsible.
People who have these kind of dangerous dogs, they've got to enclose them properly and have leashes on them and collars and not make it so they can escape easily.
The fate of the pit bulls will be decided on Wednesday. Animal Control is holding a hearing at the Bark shelter. They'll give the owners a chance to speak, and they'll also hear from witnesses to decide what to do with the dogs. It sounds like both sides are planning to show up with dozens of supporters there to plead their cases. Reporting live downtown, I'm Carrie Cavanaugh, WBAL-TV 11 News.